main part of the top of the sculpture where all the blades hang off, and this is the ball that we're getting ready to make. And right in here, these are the ball bearings that are all specified for that. Thank you. saying you gotta, when you get a commission, you go, okay, I'll try to sell this model here, and then they go, you know, we kind of like it, but we want it a little more like blah, blah, blah. So that's like model number three, and then the final one is model number four, which is, that's the piece that I actually built the sculpture from. You have?
Yeah.
Okay.
What made you become someone who makes kinetic art?
That's a tough question, isn't it? I like when the artwork's fun to look at, and so that when it moves around, it's just fun. I always like making things so that it looks like they're going to crash and they don't. Okay, now I did drawing and stuff like you guys do.
When did you start making this stuff?
When I was in college. Brian kind of bugs me about making kinetic art with like magnets or little electrical things in them, and I kind of try to stay away from that. I just want to stay on that one track. Yeah, we're just going to look at them one by one, and hopefully they'll give you guys some ideas of what you could do for your project.
Okay. Can we see this one?
Why does that one have blue pointy?
Just to look cool. You know, the big sculpture, if you've seen it out there?
Yeah.
That's the piece, that's what I made it from, is this model. So I made the model, and then everything on the big piece I measured real carefully and just made it the same, only way, way bigger. So.
It really does look cool.
How about, well, let's do this one. This one is called the Eclipse, and this is another one that I actually built that piece. It's in Westerville.
It's even got little mirrors.
Yeah. I hope you guys are thinking about your project too, so.
And not just like the faces of
the mirrors. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.